Hey guys, today we are going to be working on some massive projects and some that I've been working on off camera. And I'm really excited to show you guys what I've been doing. So yeah, let's get right into it. Alright, so it's been a week or two since I actually have recorded it, but I have been playing a lot off camera. And I'm really excited to show you guys some of the things. So let's come over here. These are the things that I have done off camera. The ice rink, I finished the outside of it and lit it up. I breeded, so I enchanted a bunch of books and added some new chests. I went on an end run. I started the castle project, which is finally, and one of my cats died from being struck by lightning. So let's go through a couple of them. So on stream, a lot of these were done on stream because I have been streaming a lot lately. I went on an end run and got a bunch of more Elytra just in case. I added some more chests here and there. I don't remember which ones are here last episode, but I know I added some of these, like, firework chests. Just some other things. I went on a run for sand. So there's sand in here. There's sand in here. There's sand in there. There is sand everywhere. So if we come over here to these chests, you can see that I have enchanted lots and lots and lots of things with using breeding as an XP source. Also, guys, I am so sorry, but during one of my streams, we were playing around, of course, doing what people do in Minecraft, and it was raining, and it started thundering, and lightning ended up killing both Mr. and Mrs. Pineapple, named by Bo Schmidt, which is my in real life friend, Keegan. But yeah, these two cats were murdered by the sky. Yeah, we were just playing around inside of the house. Oh, you guys aren't supposed to see that yet. We were playing around inside the house, and all of a sudden in chat that I saw, cats have been, like, struck by lightning or killed by lightning, and I ran outside, and both of these two were dead. And these guys usually stay together, so lightning must have struck, like, right here and killed both of them. Which is so, 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 so sad. And if we look up, there is the start of the castle. So I've been working on a couple days on this. So yeah, today we're going to be working on this. And guys, I am really liking how it's going. Most of it I did on stream so far. So if you guys want to take a look at the VOD, I'm pretty sure it's going to be on my Twitch page. But yeah, that is the start of the castle. And here is the ice rink, so you guys might be a little surprised. So yeah, I finished the entire thing, added windows, added everything. So we have a nice little inside of it. We haven't decorated the inside yet, but we will do that soon. And if you go over here, we have the entire ice rink done. So guys, this is looking very, very nice in my opinion. And we will get a higher view of it. But yeah, literally in the past like week or two that I have just been playing off camera, these are the two main projects that I've been working on, the castle and the ice rink. And actually both of these projects are the biggest projects that I've done in this world. I'd say my top three is Trump Tower, which is not really a Trump Tower, but it's just a giant building, that, and probably these two. And you could tell the scale of these builds if we go over here to the map. You could see that the castle, the ice rink is a tiny bit bigger than the castle, but the ice rink is mostly flat. But yeah, these are the two biggest projects that I've been really working on in this world, and I'm really excited to start getting them done. But yeah, real quickly, let me grab my Elytra. Where is my Elytra at? Bam, let me grab some fireworks, and we could take a look at a high sky view of these. Let's put this Elytra on. Let's go take a look. We'll fly up on top of the tower and kind of take a look. Let's go fly to the tower. And bam. Perfect landing. And if we take a look, yeah, that is the entire ice rink right there. And there's the castle that is being built. So yeah, it is the two large projects. And I'm really excited because the ice rink is kind of done now. We just need to do the inside. But I'm really excited for the castle. And by the way, I am a little bit stuffy right now. I'm not sick. It's just my throat and my nose is stuffed. So if I sound a little bit weird, forgive me. But we can kind of fly around. So the ice rink is looking really nice in my opinion. I'm actually really proud of myself because I'm usually not a very good builder. You could take a look at my other projects. But yeah, I think the ice rink is really nice. And then I'm planning out right now the castle as we speak. And you know what? We might just have to settle for this one right here. Bam. So what the plan was is kind of, I set my inspiration from the Disney castle a little bit. So what we're doing is on each corner we have four giant watchtowers. And then below that is a little L, which is like raised up until about there. You can tell this side is a little bit more polished than that side. You can tell it's raised up a little bit. And then we have another level coming up, which is this level. And then in between here we have this level that comes up a little bit past this level. And then, yeah, so the watchtower is like, how do I explain this? Each part of the castle has a certain height. So the lowest is down there, and then second highest, third highest, fourth highest, fifth highest, and then up there is the sixth highest. So it's kind of a mix of heights. And I'm thinking it's looking pretty good. So yeah, my inspiration is the kind of Disney castle with the different heights and stuff. And I'm thinking it looks pretty nice. Of course, this is like the very, very rough draft. We'll end up adding windows, banners, lights, so much cool stuff. We're going to add a garden up in the front here. We're going to be adding things in between all of these little spots. But yeah, I don't know how more I can explain it. Hopefully you guys just kind of understand what I'm trying to get to with the different heights and everything. But I'm thinking it's going to look real nice. And of course, it's going to have a nice giant tower. And yeah, it blocks the view of the pixel arts a little bit, but we'll figure it out. I think the castle is going to be a very great project. Let's take a look at it one time. I know I'm absolutely destroying this elytra, but I really want you guys to get a good little view of it. I think these two projects are going to be one of my favorite projects so far, because I'm really happy about the castle, and I'm really also happy about the ice rink. They look very, very nice. So guys, the plan for today is I do want to rebuild a fishing farm, because if you guys know, in one of the recent updates, our fishing farm actually got broken. And yeah, we just kind of tore it down, and we've got this little building here for the fishing farm, just kind of standing here doing nothing. So today we're going to be doing that. And these builds I would love to do in the episodes, but these builds takes hours and hours to actually do. So I think it'd be better if I did them off camera and just kind of showed you updates. But I really want to record this episode so I could kind of show you guys both projects before I do even more. Because if it was up to me, I would finish this castle today. But I don't want to come in an episode with a finished castle. So this is the first workings of the castle. And next episode, you'll probably see it probably done, to be honest. But yeah, today, I don't know how much stuff we're going to do, but I at least want to get the automated fishing farm done. Okay guys, so we're going to get started here, and the design we are using is Suzumo Void's design. He is one of the people that is on Hermitcraft. If you want to watch the video, I'm going to put a link in the description. So yeah, I'm going to be following his tutorial to do this. So if you guys want to build it yourselves, you guys can do that also. And I have his video right here. I'm actually watching it as we speak. So let's just start building it exactly how he is building it. So he puts a chest over here and then brings over 1, 2, just like that. Then 2 behind. Bam. And then we need to get our hoppers out. I think he has his hoppers just like that. And we'll make it a dirt block because we're classy. Just like that. Okay, so what he did is put 4 blocks in a row like that, and then 4 blocks in a row like that. Next up, put a block like that, and one into that one. Alright, now we need to get our stone pressure plates out, just like that. Then we need to get our stone walls out, place it like that, and just put a normal block behind here. Alright, and what we need to do is place a fence gate on top of there, and you know what, I think that's the wrong way. You face it like that, and then remove the block under it. Okay, now we need to get some of the quartz stairs out. I'm just using quartz because it fits the design. Place one on this side, one on this side, and then we stick our water right here. And it does seem like we have water falling from the sky also. Alright, now some more blocks. 2 on this side, and 2 on this side. And I think we might have to remove the back of the building temporarily, so we're going to go ahead and remove the back of the building. Just like that. So let's get our blocks out. Place one like here and one right there. Alright, next up, place two right here and two right here. Okay, now we come over here and we need a block in this place right there. You can go ahead and break this one. Now we need to get our slabs out. We need one slab here and one slab here. Alright, next up, we need a block right here. We need above it like that. Then a block to this side, just like that. Okay, and we need to add one block right below there. Oh, can't reach those blocks. I think that'll be fine. And it looks like we're going to have to break this side too. So we need some room over here. We'll just have to expand it a little bit. And we'll take down these stairs. Alright, next up we need three blocks in a row. So one, two, three. Just like that. Alright, next we need to make a U-shape right over here. One block over there. And a glass block right here. Okay, so now it is time for the redstone part of this build. So let's get everything out that we will need. So, where's our levers, levers? Oh, they're right there. Okay, so we gotta place that. Okay, so we're gonna need a lever right there. Switch that on. And then we're gonna need to get to the back side over here. So you know what? I'm just gonna break through this wall temporarily and put a repeater right here. And this needs to be on four ticks. And then we need to go back here and put this one on two. And two pieces of redstone right there. All right, then we need to come over here and break this block here. Okay, now comes a torch right there, a piece of redstone right there. And then we need to get up there to place a repeater. So you know, I'm just gonna go ahead and fly over there. Let's see if I can make a good landing. Oh, did I make it? Yeah, I did make it. Okay, and then a repeater right here. And it looks like I should have just maybe destroyed the building altogether because we're going to have to remove a lot of these parts. Let's just take all of these out. Alright, and then we need to bring some redstone up here. Alright, and there is only one last step to come over here to the front. Place a tripwire hooks and some string. Just like that. And the farm is actually done. It's pretty crazy. Now, I know it looks a little bit hectic with the rain and everything. This design is built for people with a mending fishing rod. You also do have to remember that. If you don't have a mending fishing rod, you will need to build a system over here to feed you fishing rods. But considering I do have a mending one, I am not going to really need that. But in Suzuma's video, he does show a fix if you don't have one, so you could watch it there. Quickly, I'm going to go grab mine so I could test the thing, and then we can make it look nice. Okay, so I grabbed my godly fishing rod, Unbreaking 3, Mending, Luck of the Sea. And I think this is the best rod you can actually get in-game, I'm pretty sure. Luck of the Sea, I think, is a little bit better than Lure, because Lure increases your chances of trash. But, yeah, so let's see if it works. So, to use this, we do have to aim down here, and then aim down. Let's see if we get any fish. Alright, it looks like we got a fish. We got a bow. Curse of Vanishing. That's pretty neat. Okay, let's close that down. So now we know the thing does work. So let's go ahead and make it look pretty. Now, I think the first thing we should do is hook up, obviously, this to the system. Before I started, I kind of just took down the system here a little bit. But we can go ahead and put this back up since I kind of know what we're doing. Let's put two of those in there. And now this is completely all my redstone at this point. Okay, then we can just go ahead and just place this just like that. Now I am going to have to break out of here somehow, so I'm just going to make a little hole right there. We do need one more hopper. Okay, bam. There is our hopper that we need. Let's fly over there again. You know what? Let's go to sleep so this rain can go away real quick. All right, we got that last hopper. Let's place that where it needs to go, right here. And then we can cover this back up just like so. So now it is back into the system. It'll start feeding it once again. And we can place things on top of here, just like that. And we could place it on top of here. And bam, and if somehow we go overflow, I can check it right here. But what, oh man, I fell. I always do that right there. I always forget about that hole. And I do have some torches with me. I don't know where I got these from, but it is perfect timing because we need a torch there, and we need a torch there, like that. All right, one more level. Put a stair here, and then for the roof, we'll have a little bit of glass. Okay, guys, so this is the building. Now, I know it looks a little bit worse than the last one just because I think this one's a little bit taller. It's a little bit more weirdly shaped. What I'm going to do is I'm going to cover up this little bit right here just because I kind of want it to be all nicely trimmed. Okay, so that is the fishing farm 2.0, and I'm going to be testing it over the next couple days to see if it works. Overall, it should work. You know what we could do real quick? Let's just throw some stuff in here. So guys, here's what I'm going to be doing. I'm going to leave my guy AFK for maybe 10 to 15 minutes, and we'll see if it works correctly and everything. So yeah, real quick. So yeah, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, I'm going to leave it, and we'll see what we get. Okay guys, so it's been a half an hour later. I think I left this going around 7, and now it is 7:30. Might have been like 40, 15 minutes, but let's see if it even worked. And bam, okay, so it did work. We already got some books going. Cool, got a saddle, name tag. So yeah, we're doing, it's actually really good, over a stack of fish, including all, in just about a half an hour. So that is actually really good. So the thing works, and we now have a fishing farm once again that I can farm at overnight. Okay guys, so today's episode might be a little short, but those two projects took a lot of my time away off camera, but we did build the fishing farm. But I do want to do one more thing before we do end off today's episode, and that is get some mushroom. So we do have a mycelium biome, but I never actually brought them over ever. Okay, so let's go ahead and grab some mushroom. And I guess we will put them in the place that we originally had the polar bears. Now we move the polar bears to their own home. So I guess we will put them right over here. So let's go get them. And this will be the last thing we do in today's episode. Like I said, a lot of time has been spent on the castle. Like, I want it to be the nicest thing in my entire world. Bam. Now here's the mycelium. So we have the fences all nice, so hopefully they won't fall into the lava. I know there's some space behind the portal, and hopefully that won't affect it much. So let's run up here. And yeah, I haven't really done anything much with the mycelium biome, but I do want to make sure to kind of have every type of animal at my home. So we can grab a couple of these, and there are plenty of these pretty much everywhere. So, okay. Let's grab you. And these are, it's weird because a lot of people forget about mycelium. They don't really pay attention to it. It's kind of like a forgotten thing in Minecraft a little bit. So let's grab you two. And you two shall come with me. There goes one. There goes the other. And bam, we are back. Now those two need to come into here. Cool. Okay, so now we have two mushroom, which is good. Now we'll be able to build a home for them later on. That'll be one of our future projects. So okay, and make home for the bears, we did that. Pixel arts, we did a couple of those. Stadium, we did that. But yeah, guys, I'm really happy. I'm going to actually start farming a lot because fishing gives you a lot of really good stuff like name tags. And obviously, enchanted books is also very, very, very nice. Okay, guys, this is going to be the end of today's episode. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed. I know today was kind of just a lot of updates with these two projects. But I'm really excited to see them develop. And hopefully, you guys are excited too. But if you did enjoy today's episode, make sure to like and comment as it supports my channel. And I'll see you guys later. God bless and goodbye.